What is the Moses trap that you discuss a lot in your book? And can you share an example of a company that fell into this particular trap? And then tell us how Steve Jobs and Apple actually escaped it.
Sure. Well, I could use the same example for both. So Steve Jobs, in his first time at Apple when he was young, and he just started it with Steve Wozniak, had this view of himself as a Moses, as this great product innovator. And he would stand on the top of the mountain and say, we're going to do this and we're not going to do that. And although that's the myth of what made him successful, that was actually a disaster. It was, in fact, what made him successful was exactly the opposite, was dropping that behavior. What happened the first time was he eventually, it kind of worked for the Apple II, and then the Apple II gradually got passed by many other PC makers, and they were trying to figure out the next thing. And he said, oh, I want to work on this Macintosh project that's over here. Everybody else working on the franchise is sort of an idiot and a bozo, and it really demotivated them and created hostility at the company, and he was leading like a Moses. This is what matters, nothing else matters. Fast forward 12 years later, he was neglecting the soldiers and glorifying the artists. Fast forward 12 years later, he gets Johnny Ive to run product design, who created all the beautiful Apple products. That's kind of the ultimate artist. And he gets Tim Cook to run everything else, all the operations and getting things done on time, on budget. Tim Cook was known as the Attila the Hun of inventory at his previous job. One was an artist, one was a soldier. He led not like a Moses, but by separating his artists and soldiers, loving them equally. And when, in fact, he passed away, his successor was the soldier, not the artist. So he'd grown from...
And he changed his mindset about praising one versus the other.
Exactly. He'd grown from, oh, I'm an artist, only artists are good, soldiers are dumb, to loving his artists, soldiers equally, and leading like a gardener rather than a Moses.